Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter study of animal tissue. In that we are studying topic nervous tissue. Now what if I say that whenever you pick a pen, the information passes from your brain to your hand by nervous tissue at a speed of electricity? Yes, that's nervous tissue. Let's study a little bit more about it. Nervous tissue. Now what's this nervous tissue? Imagine a condition, you're writing your exam paper and the examiner says that you are going to pick up the pen once I say you all to pick up. Once the examiner says that, you'll try and pick up the pen. So the information which the examiner said has translated in your ears, and from your ears the information just speeded up and went to your brain. Your brain basically processed that information and sent back to your hand that okay, now it's the time that you pick up this pen and start writing your paper. Now this information, don't you all think so, is passing with the speed of electric current? Yes, it does. And how does it pass so fast? This happens only and only because of your nervous tissue. Now there are millions and trillions of nervous tissue present in your system throughout the body. Any activity that you do is always processed by your brain, and then that command is given to various organs of your body or part, and that information is passed down with a pipeline thing which is termed as neurons. So I could say that the center of your brain consists of channels or bunches of neuron cells that basically pass behind your spinal cord and goes to the different regions of your body. So the tip of your finger will have a neuron, the tip of your toes will have a neuron, your lungs are going to have a part of neuron or a type of a neuron. Everywhere in your body, wherever command or information is needed, a neuron is present, and it basically does something which is termed as electric impulse, or information is passed with the speed of electricity. Now neurons may be of different types, for example motor neurons, sensory neurons, all different kinds of neurons are present. Neurons, the structure basically consists of nucleus, which is sensory place, dendrites, which are hair-like structures. There are Schwann cells present in the middle, and which are connected by road of Ranvier. And by connecting it to the road of Ranvier, at the end, there are cells which are termed as nerve endings. So one nerve ending of a neuron is connected to the dendrite of another neuron. Nervous tissue. Now nervous tissue is basically made up of millions of nerve cells, or you simply say neurons, and these neurons are supported by a special type of connective tissue called as neuroglial connective tissue. Now neurons are basically highly specialized cells and form the nervous system. They provide the quickest or fastest means of communication within the body and help us to give a external stimuli. For example, if you are standing at a road and a car is passing by, it is the neurons of your body that communicate at a fast speed and tell you that you need to cross the road faster or just hold back and let the vehicle pass. Now, neuron basically possess two different or distinct regions. One is the cell body or the cytosol, and another one is the soma, that's the internal structure. They have large central nucleus in them. Also, cytoplasm, rough endoplasmic reticulum, neurofibrils are important part of this. Now, the cytoplasm shows initial granules, which have very important role in protein synthesis. Students, this is the structure of a neuron containing hair-like structures called as dendrite, centripetal nucleus, and together with their nucleus and dendrite, they are termed as cell body. There is presence of axons continuously, and there is a presence of myelin sheath. The node of Ranvier basically tries to connect the myelin sheath as well as the axonal regions. And at the end of the neuron is termed as neuron terminal or the axon terminal in short. So students, in this part of the chapter, we came across the structure of a neuron, basically about nervous system we did study today. I hope you all are clear with this concept. Thank you.